So we had the ID Tech X show, and hi, so who are you?
I'm Stelios Logothetidis, director of Nanotechnology Lab and president of Hellenic Organic Wind Electronic Association. And this is the ecosystems which are built in Greece, in Thessaloniki, around the Nanotechnology Lab, where participated the Hellenic Organic Wind Electronic Association, two other startup companies, SMEs, like the BL Nano Biomed and the Organic Electronic Technologies. Around here is my colleagues, either from the Nanotechnology Lab, like Dr. Argyris Laskarakis over there, or Mr. Antonios Theodosiou, and people, my colleagues from Organic Electronics Technologies, the company produce photovoltaics, OLEDs, and sensors and biosensors. And behind of me is not the guy here now. Gentleman from BL Nano Biomed, producing biosensors from medical applications and IoT for sensors and biosensors for medical applications.
So in Greece is a good weather. You wanna use it? Use solar power?
Yeah, of course. You use the solar panel. This new technology of printed organic electronics, photovoltaics. And using various applications, either for touristic reasons, but also for other application, buildings, automotive cars, conventional cars, or electrical vehicles, green Mediterranean greenhouses, and many other applications for indoor application. We call this technology. This is a photovoltaic, printed photovoltaic. You can see if you have some light from behind, you can. Produce, if you move this, okay. Yeah. I'm not sure if you with this one, because this is LED and dispersed, but if I do this one, for example, you see the example here, or I can do this one.
Nice.
Okay, you see, I'm using this lamp and I can sign different areas, and then can produce light with these little LEDs.
Or so it's partly transparent?
Yeah, it's partly transparent. This is more transparent. This green one, for example, here, is more transparent.
Yeah.
You can see you have different colors, gray, green, blue, other red colors.
Can you introduce?
Yeah, let's start from with Argyris there for the Nanotechnology Lab.
Hello.
Hi, so who are you?
So my name is Argyris Laskarakis. I'm the head of the Organic Electronics Group of the Nanotechnology Lab, LTFM, from the University of Thessaloniki, from Greece.
So it's a Nanotechnology Lab?
Exactly.
So it says Aristotle.
Yeah, you know,
Aristotle University.
Yeah,
is that the name of it?
Yeah, exactly. It's the biggest university in Greece, in the second largest city in Greece. So our laboratory has unique infrastructures in the world for the fabrication of organic and printed electronics. We have 45 expert scientists from different disciplines working in the fields of nanotechnologies, organic and printed electronics, but also nanomedicine and optical engineering.
And this is the kind of infrastructure you have?
Exactly. Unique pilot lines for fabrication of flexible, organic, and printed electronics over a large area. You can see a small module like this. So actually, we have a vision. We want to create energy harvesting materials and devices in order to adapt it into different surfaces and objects in the everyday life to make everything create energy from the sun.
And so how many people are there?
Around 45 people, 45 expert scientists.
And are you doing groundbreaking stuff?
Exactly.
Like nobody else is doing?
Exactly. Actually, we are working in the fields of nanotechnology, organic printed electronics, through European research and development projects, which are competitive projects. And actually, we form consortia with other experts from other countries, from Europe and outside Europe, to move on and promote these cutting-edge research fields.
All right. Can you introduce some of your colleagues?
Yeah, exactly. So, my colleague.
Yeah. Let's come right here. This
Hello.
Hi.
This is Antonis Theodosiou, expert in the organization of international conferences, which is a big part of our activities in the Nanotechnology Lab.
So, hi, so who are you?
Hello, I'm Antonis Theodosiou, I'm responsible for the organization of the big international organic electronics event in Thessaloniki. This is a nanotechnology event. It's organized for 16th year in a row in Thessaloniki.
When is it next time?
In the beginning of July, from 29th of June until 6th of July. This is a multi-event. It's comprised of three separate conferences and summer schools and exhibition. We host more than 1,000 people and 750 presentations from 60 countries. We host more than 50 exhibitors. We host more than 200 matchmaking meetings. And
is this
this
one
is
of them?
Part of the total the full event. This is the conference on flexible organic electronics, and this is the 3D conference, the 3D printing, 3D bioprinting, and additive manufacturing.
All and people them, come from around the world?
Yes, we have visitors and participants from over 60 countries all over the world.
16 years already?
16 years already, yes. This is 60 year in a row.
Nice, so this is a great plan for July, right?
Yes, of course.
And end of June.
We welcome and we invite all the people to come and participate in this full
cool.
event.
Can you introduce the company over there?
Yes, of course. This is the BL Nanobiomed. It's a company, a nanomedicine company.
Doing nanomedicine.
Nanomedicine company. One of the main products is a full printable biosensor for detection of diseases. And they are also activated in 3D bioprinting for
what application? The guy who is responsible, it's not here at the moment, but this is a company which produces implants, first of all, biosensors, 3D bioprinting systems, which are fully integrated for various applications like diseases or tissue analogous development application in tissue engineering, but also by sensors for medical or IoT application in medical application. They work with the other company, the organic electronic technology companies, which are fully printed company. And Marius will talk to us just now. They work these two companies together in printing biosensors and working together to develop all this stuff for various applications, because organic electronic technologies, as Darius will explain to us, works fully in printed electronics, either for photovoltaics or for OLEDs or RFIDs or sensors, biosensors, and work together with BL Biomed. So Darius,
Hi.
Hello, so who are you?
I'm Darius, I'm the business development manager of Organic Electronic Technologies, a company coming from Greece. You can see some of our applications right here, so it's more easy and convenient for you. For example, we've done some reference projects with greenhouses, also in cooperation with Fiat, and also some sunbeds. And we're one of a kind because we can produce also in free form lasers, so no other company can do that worldwide.
So that means you can make logos and stuff?
Yes, it's free because we have the equipment and the technology to do that. So, but the main application is still the OPVs.
Hi.
We can use it in the building integration, so you can see also some application there in the facades of buildings, just in order to produce electricity. It will give support to the power needed for a building. And we are also now developing different products for commercial issues with our guy.
Hi, so who are you?
I'm Chrysostomos Varlamis. I'm a product developer for Organic Electronic Technologies. This is actually our product. It's a full panel of organic solar cell. This is the stuff we put on buildings, on cars, on Mediterranean greenhouses to harvest energy and produce power.
What's the efficiency?
The efficiency, it's around 5.5%.
5.5?
Yeah, that's right.
So, and this flexible material, it's like printed electronics, so how does it work?
Yeah, it's a fully solution processed. In a,
you can come here to see how it works. I will turn off the TV because you have the full video.
It's a full solution processed on a roll-to-roll production line.
All right. No problem. So, roll-to-roll mass production?
Roll-to-roll, it's for mass production. Yeah, it's a printing technique used for many years. And we use it mainly for mass production.
Do you need a higher efficiency to launch mass production, or is it ready now?
This is already a product, but we always strive for better efficiency and better stability to have a better product in the end of the day.
All right. How do you do this kind of R&D?
We have a team of people, researchers, that work on specific areas for each part of the organic photovoltaic.
Cool. All right. You even have something that looks like a playing card.
Yeah. That's actually our RFID antennas inside, our printed RFID antennas.
All right. It looks like a box you can buy.
Yeah, this is our smart packaging solution. We have implemented our organic photovoltaics. This has a smart circuit inside. We use light. And when it works like a detector, when the OPV is shaded, we have a signal.
So it charges up the battery
It charges up a capacitor, a supercapacitor. And when there is a difference in...
It lights up over there.
It lights up, yeah.
Yeah. Lights up. And then you have a video to explain. What is in your video?
It's a company video, so you can see
You
can see the whole production line more in details and all the applications.
Okay, 1 second.
The first one is only 60 seconds. You can get a really holistic idea about the products we can offer.
So, for this to be the future, it needs to be great price, large quantities. How soon?
Yes, in 1, 2, 3 years. Depends how much they ask for end users and customers. If you need 100 meters, 1,100 meters, square meters, 1 million square meters, depends. The cost depends on the order. And of course, depends on materials or our customers, our suppliers. So these two end users, orders, and suppliers are interrelated, which we have high orders, reduce the cost by a factor of 5, 10, 15, whatever they are, but depends on the quantity.
So it's potentially cheaper than existing solar systems?
No, not at all day.
Not yet.
Not yet, because if you produce 1 square meter, then the cost is high. But if you produce 1 million square meters, then the cost will be similar with conventional, let's say, silicon technology products.
In the future, the price could be lower?
Yes, this is, of course, first of all, the most green technology. In 2025, for example, to 2030, the price will be reduce and will be less than the price of silicon technology nowadays, but the applications which the new application comes either from green houses, greenhouses for buildings integration or for automotive in electrical vehicle, for example, are unique, and it's the only technology which can be applied to this kind of application. Or in other applications you saw earlier, which are indoor applications where you need the low power for electrical devices, for supermarkets in order to advertise or to support, let's say, all of this, for or electrical circuits to start working. It's a unique technology to be applied. Of course, you can. There is no problem with the price because you need small pieces. You can start directly and you can have several customers who make orders these days also.